Hello and welcome back to our ISE YouTube channel. My name is Antonio Torres and I will be covering one of the new features in ISE 2.1, single sign-on for sponsor and guest portals using PingFederate as our identity provider solution through Security Assertion Markup Language, or SAML. Let's go through a quick overview. SAML is an XML-based standard for exchanging authentication and authorization data between security domains. It specifies three roles: the identity provider, just the one hosting the single sign-on services, in this case PingFederate; the service provider, in this case Cisco Identity Services Engine, the instance holding the application that the user or the principal will try to access. In a typical SAML SSO flow, the service provider will request and obtain an identity assertion from the identity provider. And based on this result, ISE can perform policy decision based on the attributes that we're retrieving during the authentication process. In this case, the IDP will be configured to return to ISE two particular attributes, the member of and email address for that particular user object in Active Directory. Let's say the user is trying to access the sponsor portal hosted in ISE. ISE will redirect the user to an authentication portal that it's hosted directly on the identity provider. Here, the user types Active Directory credentials. Those credentials are validated against Active Directory infrastructure through an LDAP call. And the PingFederate server will retrieve the member of and the email attributes, and it will generate a success event to ISE. At this point, the user should see the success page on the sponsor portal, and it should experience single sign-on as long as the session is still alive on the identity provider side.
Let's cover some of the configuration. The first step, it's going to be really simple. We're going to prepare ISE to use an external SAML identity provider. And to do that, we're going to go to Administration, Identity Management, External Identity Sources. On the left side, you'll see the SAML Identity Providers option. We're going to add a new instance. In this case, I do have it already. But in this step, the only thing that we really require is basically to provide an identity provider name. We can add a quick description and save changes. That's it. We're not going to complete the rest of the configuration because the only purpose of this step is just to create the SAML Identity Provider index that we can, or the instance that we can call later from the sponsor portal configuration side. So the next step is to prepare the sponsor portal to authenticate users through a single sign-on solution. So let's go to Work Centers, Guest Access, Configure. I'm gonna go to Sponsor Portals. In this case, I'll be using the sponsor portal default. We can create a new one if necessary under the portal settings. Let's just expand portal settings. We're going to select PingFederate, which is the instance that we just created under identity source sequence. And also in this case, I'm going to create a custom full qualified domain name so we can call the sponsor portal in a much easier way. Normally, if you're familiar with the portals in the ISE 1.3 and up, the URLs are really long because they have all this information. Part of it's going to be the portal ID. So instead, I'm going to just type a full qualified domain name, a custom FQDN that I already have as a DNS record in my environment, pointing to ISE IP address. So I'm going to save that. And if you take a look on the right side, you'll see that the sponsor flow looks like SSO login followed by an AUP acceptance and then sponsor home. And this is pretty much it from configuration side on the sponsor portal itself. If we take a look at the new URL, it's going to be like this. And the next step, it's going to be to configure the identity provider itself, PingFederate, to support the authentications coming from ISE. And to configure the identity provider, the first step will be to export the necessary information from ISE. So let's go to Administration, Identity Management, External Identity Sources. And under the SAML Identity Providers, we're going to click on the instance that we created previously. And under Service Provider Info, let's click Export. So here, ISE will generate a zip file that contains basically individual XML file for each portal that it's using SAML in its flow. So if we extract this, we will see an XML file for our sponsor portal default XML. We can see another one up here because I'm currently using another SSO on another portal, but this is the one that we'll be using for this example. When this is the metadata that we're going to be importing into the service provider connection settings. And to do that, let's go to the PingFederate site. I won't be covering the entire configuration on the PingFederate site. Actually, it's a very long config, and I already covered that in an article that I'll be referencing down under additional information. So the document, it's already going through step-by-step all details that you need to know about the PingFederate configuration site. So what I'll do is I'll cover a few of the critical things in the video so we can jump back to ISE and complete the configuration there. So back to the SP connections, we're going to create a new connection. Here, we don't really have to modify any settings. Once we get to the import metadata, we're going to select file. And here, we're going to point to the XML file that we exported in the previous step from ISE. Click Next, so the PingFederate will process this XML file. And I'm gonna get an error because in this case, there's already a connection created for this particular portal. But what I'm gonna do is hit Cancel and go back to the connection that we already have. So we can go through a couple of things that are worth to mention. Again, the whole configuration, it's step-by-step in the document. So if we take a look, the first thing that is critical is to work on the data store integration. Part of the basic configuration when it comes to PingFederate is to add a valid data store. In this case, I'm using an LDAP connection. And you need to specify the base DN for the user lookup. In this case, this is the structure I'm using. And the LDAP filter, it's going to be this for username specifically. And then there are two additional attributes that we have to configure within this process. And it's the email address and the member auth, so that the PingFederate can actually retrieve this information during the user authentication process. And that's how, when we create the success event to ISE, we can include this information about this particular Active Directory object. Pretty much, once you're done with the SP configuration steps and save the changes, and the connection status is set to active, the next step will be to export that connection data so we can use it in ISE. And to do that, we're going to go to Server Configuration, Administrative Functions, and then Metadata Export. Since the PingFederate is right now configured to act as a identity provider and also as an SP, we're going to select the first option, click Next, and then we're going to select information to include in metadata manually instead of automatically. So not much to modify here. We're definitely using SAML v2 as protocol. Click Next, and now that we're in the signing key section, we're going to select what is the certificate that we're going to be using for our digital signature. It's part of our certificate validation process that will happen for every exchange between the PingFederate and ISE. Click on Next, and for the metadata signing, we're going to select the certificate. This certificate is part of the configuration when we're creating the service provider connection itself. We have the ability to import a certificate, the certificate that we want to use, or we can choose to generate a self-signed certificate as well. So we're not using encryption in this use case. It's up to the network admin. So once we click Next, we get to the summary page, and then from here, we can export the file. Again, this is an XML file. There's another XML file that we're going to save locally. Then we're going to use this file in ISE. So I'm going to just save it. The next step is to go back to ISE and complete the configuration there. So back into ISE, let's go to Administration, Identity Management, External Identity Sources, and then let's select our SAML Identity Provider instance. So the idea here is we need to import the metadata that we just exported from the PingFederate site. So we're going to go to Identity Provider Config, and we're going to click Browse. Select the XML data, and once we process this information, you should see all the information that we're importing here populating automatically. This, I already did it. That's the reason why it was already here. And this is pretty straightforward. The next step is to configure ISE to process those extra two attributes that we're passing from the PingFederate site. So we're going to go to groups, and we're going to type under the group membership attribute, we're going to type member of the way we are expecting to receive this attribute from the PingFederate site. So it's going to be member of, And then for the specific group details that we're expecting, we're going to add under the name in assertion, we need to specify the distinguished name for that particular group or groups that we're expecting to receive from the PingFederate side. So in my case, I'm using this one right here, Tor, that it's basically part of rtp.net. So once we're done with this, continue with attributes. And under attributes, we're going to add a new one. And this new attribute, it's going to be male. It's already there. You can see it in the background. But basically here, the only thing you need to type, it's the name of the assertion, in this case, male. And name in ICE is going to be exactly the same, male. Type, it's going to be string and no values that you need to specify. So it should look like this. Once you're done with this, just safety changes. I'm going to just reset this because it was already there. But once you complete these steps, we have successfully configured ICE to interact with the PingFederate to receive those two extra attributes as part of the authentication process. Now, the final step is go to the advanced settings. This is important because it's not there by default. And we need to enable logout. So basically, the reason it's because we need to make sure that we're allowing the sponsor portal to initiate a logout event from ICE, and ICE should be able to notify the logout event to PingFederate. So what we're going to be using here is the email attribute or the mail attribute that we just configured. It should be available in the drop-down menu, and we're going to check this option to sign logout request. Now, safety changes again. And then that's concluding the global configuration for the PingFederate interaction. The next step is to configure the sponsor group mappings. To do that, let's go to Work Center, Guest Access, Configure. And under Sponsor Groups, I'm going to be working with the sponsor all accounts, which is the group that will allow the sponsors not only to control its own accounts, but also every single account created by any other sponsor. We're going to click on members. Here, it's already PingFederate instance. Usually, if the first time you're configuring this, you'll on the right side, you should only see all accounts. As you can see, there's also an Active Directory group instance because I'm using Active Directory for other flows. But in this flow, we're not relying on Active Directory lookup directly from ICE, but we're relying completely in the PingFederate instance for enforcing the authentication. So this is the instance that we just created, PingFederate con Tor. We're going to select this option. We're going to click Save, and this is pretty much it. The rest is just typical configuration under the sponsor portal. We're going to save the changes. And once we're done with this, we are ready to verify the flow. To verify the flow, let's go back to Work Center's Guest Access, Configure, and under Sponsor Portals. This is the Sponsor Portal instance we configured in the first place. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a portal test. As you can see, we didn't even see the actual Sponsor Portal as it should look like, which is right here. This is how it should look like, our sponsor portal. Instead, we are being redirected to the PingFederate sign-on page because there are no active sessions for this event. So I'm going to type a test user that it's part of the Tor group, login. And as you can see, we're getting redirected to the sponsor portal. So now we should be able to create accounts. I'm going to just randomly create a couple of accounts here. The first thing that we're verifying is the member of attribute being delivered. We can conclude that the member of attribute is delivered correctly because the only way we can log into the sponsor portal as a all accounts sponsor group is if we are members of that particular Active Directory group. So we know that part is working at this point. Now, the other part that we need to verify is the email being delivered as part of the authentication process. So if we go to Manage Accounts, and we click on one of these accounts that we just created, we can select the resend. And if we select email, we should be able to see the email address associated to that particular object. Now, is that the right email address? Well, you know, we can just verify that real quick. Let me just bring up my Active Directory instance. And let's look for that particular object. It's right here. And the user I just type is this one right here. And this is the email associated with that particular AD object. So it's the right email address. But this is only from the flow perspective. Now, the last thing that you want to verify is if single sign-on is working fine. So the next time we can go manually launch the sponsor portal again, let's say sponsor portal using the custom FQDN. And this time we're in with no login prompt. As long as the session is still alive on the identity provider side, we should not have to type credentials anymore. Now, this is only from the portal perspective. If we want to see it from logging perspective, if we go back to ICE, we can go to administration, login, and under debug log configuration for this particular PSN, there is a particular component for SAML. So I have these two components set to debugging. So if we want to verify how everything looks, we can SSH the box and we can verify live the login event. And just to make sure that we're catching the entire process, I'm going to go back to the sponsor portal and I'm going to trigger a logout event or a signout event. Again, since we're logging out, ICE is notifying the identity provider about this particular logout event, which causes the user to get redirected back to the original authentication portal that it's enforced by the identity provider. So since the session is no longer active, let's monitor from logging perspective. So the debug component that we enabled are SAML specific, and this is going to be under ICE PSE.log. So let's just tell this logs real quick. And let me bring up the portal. Let's actually launch the portal completely. You'd see some information in there, but what we want to see is the actual login event. So now that we have full access, let's take a look at the logs real quick. We can try to filter based on the actual identity that we're using, but it's really simple. All we want to see is ICE trying to call PingFederate for that particular authentication. And here are the details. And the second part, it's we want to see the attributes are as the PingFederate is awarding those attributes to ICE. So if we go back, this is the information that we are getting. As we can see, PingFederate is responding back with a success. And in this case, is a subject is the identity itself. It's a status set to success. And then we're delivering the email address as it is in the Active Directory object. Now, if we keep going down, we will see that the group is also being passed as expected. The member of attribute is delivered as expected right here in this line. And this is followed by a overall success. So this is how it should look like, and that's pretty much it. From verification perspective, any kind of troubleshooting would come down to enabling the SAML components and going back to ICE PSE and verifying if there's something broken exactly at what step we're breaking and if we're getting the necessary information that ICE requires for authorizing that sponsor session. This completes this video about PingFederate and ICE for sponsor portal SSO integration. Keep in mind that everything discussed here has been high level. For more specific information and configuration step for this flow, I'll be including the links under the video description section for both guest and sponsor portal single sign-on integration with PingFederate.